With less than a week to go before Chinese New Year and the recent announcement of return of hair salons during MCO 2.0, hairdressers and barbers are seeing a surge of customers. Many said they are glad that the announcement came before the festive season.
Soon as the SOPs came out, the new ones, I called AB straight away because my son's hair was getting really long and my husband's hair too. And I don't know how to cut hair, so we needed the salons to open, especially Chinese New Year's around the corner.
Yeah, it's good actually before Chinese New Year for us to have a touch up before the New Year starts.
其实是不错啦，因为我们有办法去剪掉我们长长的头发了，不然过年会比较难看了，人也是比较舒服，这样。
While the daily COVID-19 numbers are still quite high, patrons said as long as the hairdressers and barbers adhere to the SOP, they will be confident to step into their shops.
Well, I think that's why we always come back to the people we know. Like, we're quite familiar with AB, so I think, and he has all the PPEs and safety procedures and all that. So I think we're quite comfortable, but we wouldn't be going anywhere.
ABX co-salon owner A.B. Wong said his salon was already fully booked with the previous appointments. And now with the festive season, they have been busier than before.
就在4号开业的时候，我们要把之前已经 submit 的 appointment 先做一个 priority 给他们先来先，然后接下来其实我们的 appointment 已经是满满了，然后我们就可能就找一个小时开，吃一个小时关这样。
Even though salons see a surge in demands, business owners said they are still far from recovering the losses since the first MCO.
因为这次的 SOP 只是给剪头发而已，所以就是可能一些 chemical 的动作是做不到的，所以可能就是损失那些做 chemical， 可是就没有办法，就是可以开已经是一个很好的开始了。
Malaysian Hairdressing Association President and salon owner Michael Paul said, usually during super peak period, salons can earn up to 4 times extra. But this year, his business has suffered a drop of at least 50%.
But I think nowadays, because of the pandemic and this MCO, I think the environment of the Chinese New Year is not so strong. Yeah. I think people not really care. And second thing, because we only allow to cut hairs only. Mm. So this will affect our business a lot.
Nonetheless, he said salon owners shouldn't rush the government to allow for a full range of services.
As a president of MHA, if we rushing and we write in, why not give us the full service? I think it's not the right time. Before this, because the cases are less. In the whole country, maybe 30, 20 cases only. But now it's 2,000-3,000 per day. But maybe I hope in future, when the cases slow down, okay, come down, so the government will be follow back the first MCO, the SOP.
While barbers are not bothered so much with offering a full range service, Jiro Yap said they are more prepared to handle the surge of customers during the reopening. He said even though there is a surge in customers compared to this time last year, it is still 50% lesser.
觉得都是因为 COVID， 然后加上 MCO 吧。有一些我们的客人可能从比较远的地方来的，就会变成不会打算去到这样远，可能他们就在自己的小区捡，这样就流失了一部分的客人这样子。While
he is not sure how long more before he cover all his losses, he is glad to see most of his customers are back. He said it is important to adhere to the SOP so that it continues to give customers the confidence to come back.